today, I didn't do anything. And that's becoming a problem. And I don't mean like, oh, I didn't get in the house, blah, blah. I mean, I didn't do anything. Like, I cooked, and that was it. And so, problem is there. Fine. Well, today, I was, sorry, my brain went blank again. I don't know. It's like for some reason I turned this camera on and I just want to go, But today I had, washed some clothes and I washed some clothes yesterday. Today I got them. I was like, I put a pair of pants on and I was like, huh, did I dry them too long or something? I have one pair that's a little bit snugger than the others. Not sure why. They're all the same brand, and like three of them that are the same brand, same color, same everything. One of them is just made a little bit smaller, and it's like these are kind of snug. And then Thor's laying here. I just now looked in my viewfinder and realized it looks like I'm doing something to somebody beside me, but not my dog Thor sitting here beside me. Chloe's sitting at my feet. But so I was like, okay, so I went and weighed myself. I weigh more right now than I ever have in my entire life, and I don't like it. So, and I know part of it is because I got the new job, and instead of running around the house chasing my son, I'm sitting at a desk for 8 hours. But I didn't change, you know, my eating habits or anything. And I think I increased them because I'm like, oh, I'm sitting here and it's the mindless snacking. Because right now, my willpower for that has gone away a lot since Adrian's come around, because it's like, it's really hard to go, okay, breakfast, lunch, dinner, and you eat those times. It's like, okay, it's dinner, it's, okay, generally like breakfast or lunch, Christy is generally gone or something, but her dinner time, it's like, okay, it's really hard to get him to eat, so sometimes one of us would eat while the other one's watching, then we'd switch, and then the other one would eat while the other watched. And so you kind of like, you'd snack, you'd eat when you could. And when you're at an office for 8 hours a day, well, and you're like doing a training video, or you're waiting on something to compile, or you're waiting on something to install, bag of chips or candy or something. And I've been doing that a lot. So like, my clothes still fit. So it's just that this one pair that I have, there's just a little bit snugger than the others. And it's not like, I have to wear it with a belt either way, because they used to fall off of me. Now I wouldn't have to wear a belt with them. And I'm like, I don't like that. So, and actually I think, sure, this arm, this thing right here, and this little, this black thing over here that you see in the viewfinder, or in the viewfinder, the last thing in the viewfinder that you see on your screen, it's an elliptical, but that could be elliptical stair stepper thing. And I just don't use it. It's like my self-dedication right now for this is, I went to zero. And I've been making excuses like, oh, I'm not going to the gym because of the people for New Year's and all this other crap. That's exactly what it is. It's an excuse. It's not excusable. I need to become dedicated, because I understand with modern medicine, we can make you live as long as your body can survive, as barring you come down with something that will kill you. But it's the quality of life you'll have. I know a lot of, I've known people that where I grew up, this one woman, she walked, swept her front porch every day, and then she lived a good life. I mean, she was always seemed healthy, and literally just one day she didn't come out to sweep her porch. People got worried because she was always outside working, doing something. Doesn't matter. I mean, every day in the morning, she swept her porch. Summer, winter, spring, fall, didn't matter. But she, just one day she didn't do it. And I mean, because her routine was so set, people got worried. And they thought that she might have been sick, but she had passed in her sleep. But her quality of life was always really high because she was always active. Other people I know were large. They didn't really exercise. And the last few years of their life, they would spend in a wheelchair, or they would just could not. Somebody had to take care of them. And I don't want to be that. I want to be healthy my entire life. I want to be, when I'm in my 90s, I hope I live that long. I still want to be able to have a good mind. I still want to be able to get up. Because where I work, there's a guy that's 82 years old that comes into work and does his job. And I'm like, wow. I mean, he wears your hearing aid in each ear, but other than that, he looks really healthy. The guy that's retiring, I'm basically doing his position, he runs. I don't mean jog. He's a runner. Every day on lunch, I mean, it doesn't matter. If it's 40 degrees, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, lunch, he puts on his running clothes and runs. And I thought, oh, he must mean he jogs. I was going to lunch to go to McDonald's. Wait, did I go to McDonald's? Where did I go that day? I felt bad because I was like, wow, I think it was McDonald's and I got a Big Mac. And as I'm driving back, eating my fries, I see this guy that's over double my age running in 30 degree weather. I mean, I think it was around 30 to 35 degrees that day. And he's running, and I'm stuffing my face with a Big Mac and Fretlin supersized fries. And it's just, makes me feel really bad. I really need to get off my butt. And I would exercise right now. Now this is an excuse, but this one I'm gonna say is valid, because if I exercise, it's gonna wake Adrian up. That means I won't be able to sleep for a long time. But what I am gonna do is tomorrow at 8 p.m., I'm going to the gym. I don't know. I think tomorrow I'm just going to do some cardio, and because it's really hard to exercise here, and because, I mean, this is an excuse also, but I mean, really, I could get on this thing every day and be in a good cardiovascular health. But I want to be stronger. I want to get to more. My physique to be better. So yeah, this is a kind of a downer, but I just don't like it. But anyways, something else that happened today. If you're a wrestling fan, you probably know this. If not, you might remember this guy, Superfly Jimmy Snuka. He passed away today. That made me very sad. I mean, if you don't know who he is, he's the guy that you see, he holds his hands up like that, and he jumps off the top of the steel cage onto, I think it's during WrestleMania 1, or I can't remember. But he jumped off, this basically the one that made Mick Foley jump off the top of his house and do all the crazy stuff he did. So yeah, he passed away, but he was an older, I think he was senile, I think he had cancer. So, I mean, I think he had a lot of problems. And he took a great number of drugs throughout his entire life. It's that kind of, like, I don't like it when anybody passes away. I don't wish that upon anybody. But that's the genre I'm a big fan of, wrestling. I've always been a fan of wrestling. A lot of the wrestlers that I grew up with, when things happen to them, it's very sad. It's like with the music I listen to, like movie stars, things like that. If you're a huge fan of a certain type of movie and somebody in that genre passes, it makes you feel the bad. That's the way I am about wrestlers. Problem is with wrestling, most of them get on drugs, or the work they do puts their body through so much that quite a few have passed since I've been alive. But anyway, I am not going to end this vlog on a horrible note, because this has been kind of a downer. I do want to talk about self-discipline, which I kind of have. In the past, I know I can do it, because when I was in college, I was very fit. I could bench a lot. I had a six pack. I was in really good health. But at that time, like I think I said before, when I worked out, I did like an Ironman workout. I think it's what it's called. It's where you work out every muscle in your body every time. And no, I'm not going to do that. That's just stupid. But one, it takes a long time, and two, you're not really giving your body time to rebuild. But now I'm going to go split it up so I do have it. But self-discipline is something that really everybody needs in numerous aspects of their life. And it's just not like to work out, it's with eating, it's like the right types of food, not spending all day on video games or reading books or watching TV. I mean, I have two dogs and a son and a wife. And that's just my immediate family. I have dog hair in my mouth. That's one of the benefits of owning a dog. He's down here, he's asleep, and he's kind of doing, kicking his legs, his little puppy dream. But I really, but basically what I'm doing is I'm trying to, you have to divide your time up. You can't go, well, I want to play a video game. You can do that, but you can't really act upon it. It's not like, I just want to beat this final boss, or I want to play one more game of Smite, or I want to do this one more time. Because you are neglecting other aspects of your life. And at this point, I am trying to, this kind of falls into the live into the now aspect also that I've talked about. But self-discipline actually helps a lot, a great deal with the living in the now aspect that I've talked about previously in my vlogs. I'm trying to build up my discipline. I'm trying to make it to work. Somebody else I know. This guy I used to work for, he was a vegetarian, but he loved meat and everything. But he had watched, he went to a seminar or something, I can't remember what he said it was, but he knew as long as he could live as a vegetarian, even though he wanted to eat meat, he would have the discipline to run his business properly. And I'm like, I can understand that. So if as long as he know that, as he can not eat meat, he knows that if he has that much discipline to not do that, he has the discipline to do right by his business. And that's what I'm trying to get to. If I have the discipline to be healthy, to take care of myself, I can be there for my family. And that's what I'm trying to do. I mean, I understand my dogs aren't going to live probably more than 10 more years, if that. I hope they live. as long as they can. This thought of not having them is very sad to me. And I could probably live a crap life and still be able to get around with them. But my son, I want to see him graduate high school. I want to see him get married. I want to see if he has kids or adopts kids or whatever. I want to be there for all that. And if I don't have the discipline to take care of myself, I won't. And in this day and age, the way college tuition is, just home prices and everything, he may need, I mean, I'm not saying he may need help though getting through all this. And it's like, when I went to college originally, it cost $1,200 a semester at a in-state tuition for a university. And today, that same university, I think it's $12,000 if you stay in the dorms, but it's like, I think it's $8,000 if you don't. But yeah, I'm like, it's went up a great deal, but salaries haven't went up that much since then. So it's like, what do you do? It's like now it's, if you're going into college, it's very hard to do it. And if I don't have the discipline to take care of myself, keep a job, save money, I may put my son in starting out in life in huge debt. I mean, I understand that not everybody can help their kids out, but I'm gonna try to do everything I can to do it, because I don't want him to be like, all right, I've graduated college, I'm already $100,000 in debt, and they don't own a house, they don't own a car. I'll be able to get him a car that he can drive around college, but it's be like, okay, he has an old car, he has no job, no house, and you're already $100,000 in debt. And everybody's like, oh, that's good debt. No, it's debt. And I understand, yes, you may be able to pay it off with a job and you're helping yourself, but I don't want him to have that. And that's all about self-discipline, what I need. And I'm hoping I'm kind of trying to help. And it's also kind of me talking about this, I'm hoping it might help somebody go, wow, I understand what he's saying, and I kind of see why he would do it, and maybe it might help you. I mean, you're going to see me every day. I make a vlog every day, so I'm going to catalog my journey through all this, and I might not tell every aspect of it, but going to the gym and stuff like that, I will. What I probably want to do is I might take a picture of myself in the mirror every day, and I'm not going to show it, because right now I look horrible, but I'll take a picture of myself in the mirror every day, and when I get to the point that I think that I like, I might actually show everybody doing montages, like from where I started to today. Well, it'll be tomorrow, Monday. Oh, my watch is dead, dang it. So I think Friday was the 13th, Saturday was the 14th, the 15th was Sunday, July 16th. It'll be the first day starting, and maybe 2 months from now. I want to think about it, because I want to do it to where if I can lose, no, I mean more than 2 months. Thinking I could probably lose 2 pounds a week. That's a pretty good, I mean, that's not a horrible objective. I mean, that's doable. So it's 8 pounds a month, 16 pounds in 2 months. If I lost 16 pounds, I'd be doing pretty good, but I'd need to really, 3 months, 24 pounds. I hope I could do more than 24 pounds in 3 months. In 3 months, I hope I could do, well, let's see. If I lost 30 pounds, that's down to my college weight. I wouldn't be in the shape I was in college, but that'd be down to my college weight. But I'm not gonna do that because just working, I'm gonna make it difficult. But I'm gonna catalog it. Hope everybody will enjoy it. And I'm gonna talk about my workout. I've actually in my bag, my workout bag, I have a new field notes book. I'm actually gonna keep track of how much what I do, how much weight I lift, the exercise I do, how much weight I lift, how many sets I do, and how many reps I do. And I'll keep track of that. I'll let everybody know how I do on it. And hopefully, I'll take you guys along on my journey. And just me talking to this camera is going to help me do this because, one, me saying I'm going to do this, and if I don't, then I have to sit in front of this camera and go, I didn't do it. I've gained so much more weight, and that I don't want to do. But, so, workout time tomorrow. Tomorrow I will probably do cardio, so I'll let everybody know how that goes. Hopefully the people from the New Year stuff is gone. And I'm not doing a New Year's resolution. My New Year's resolution is not losing weight or anything like that, because New Year's resolutions are made to be broken. But anyways, I'm gonna get off here. I've rambled on about this stuff too much. Hope you guys had a good day. I had a pretty good day. I mean, I've always said any day that I can stay at home and not do anything is a good day because it relaxes me. But I spend a lot of time with the family. I really like that. So Sundays, that's like on the seventh day he rested. Well, on the seventh day, I'm going to rest. So Sundays, I probably won't work out, but Monday through Friday will be workout days. Saturday is probably going to be a day going out with the family. Sunday is the day to stay in with the family. But anyways, sorry, I said I'm going to end it. I'm going to end it now. See you guys tomorrow.